fraction of fraction is same as addition of fraction. The same method, the same step. Only you know the difference that instead of plus, you are going to do minus. So I'm going to give you a few more examples. We'll do it very quickly. So let's say if it's 8 by 10 and 5 by 10. So it's 8 minus 5 by 10. That is 3 by 10. So can you see it is as easy as addition, right? So the same thing you're going to do in subtraction as well. So let's see one more sum. If the question is, let's say 2 by 4 and 2 by 6. Right? Now I cannot subtract this directly because the denominators are not same. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to find the LCM. So as you can see, I have done the LCM. You all know how to find the LCM. This is a long division method. You can do this method, division method, or you can do any other method to find the LCM. This method is very easy, so I have used this method. So 2 2's are 4, 4 3's are 12. So the LCM is 12. So once you have found the LCM, what you need to do is to change the denominator into this particular number. So I'm going to do that. So 2 by 4 into, so with what number if you multiply by 4 you will get 12, 3, right? So up also 3, 2 by 6, so again with what number you multiply 6 you will get 12, 2, correct? So 6 2's are, so up also 2. Okay, so we have done this step. So let's see what do we get. 2 3's are 6, 6 by 12, and 2 2's are 4, 4 by 12. So now I got the number. So now I can easily subtract as the denominators are same. So 6 minus 4 by 12, that is equal to 2 upon 12. So this is the answer for the subtraction sum. So when you get two different denominators, you are going to find the LCM and you are going to proceed with the steps. Now we will see one more step with the help of mixed fraction. So let's do one more example, that is 3 minus 1 by 3. Now if you see, this number is whole number and whereas this is a fraction. So what you are going to do is you are going to convert the whole number into fraction. It's very simple, just you need to put upon 1. So now as you can see, the denominators are different. So what I am going to do is I am going to make the denominators same. How? By taking the LCM. Now if I tell you, if in any question you get a denominators 1 and 3 or 1 and any number, the other number will be always the LCM. So here the LCM is 3. I repeat, whenever you get 1 or any other number along with it and you have to find the LCM, the other number will be always the LCM. So here 3 is going to be the LCM. So how am I going to make this 1 3? I have to multiply it by 3. So up also by 3. Minus 1 by 3, 3 is already the same, so I'm going to just put into 1. So 3 3's are 9, 9 upon 3, minus 1 upon 3. Now the denominators are same, so what you're going to do is, you're going to just subtract it, 8 by 3. So this is an improper fraction, so I have to convert it into a mixed fraction. So that is, 3 will come down, 3 2's are 6. 6 plus 2, 8. So you can check it. 3 2's are 6. 6 plus 2, 8. So 8 by 3 is your answer. So this one more sum which contains both addition and subtraction of fraction. Let's see how we will do that. Okay, so let's see the sum. So as I told you here, both addition and subtraction is there. So let's see how to do. So as you can see, the denominator is 6, 2 and 4. They all are different. So what we need to do is we need to find the LCM. 6, 2, 4. So I'm going to take 2. 2 3's are 6. 2 1's are 2. 2 2's are 4. Again I'm going to take 2. I cannot divide 3 by 2. So I'm going to write 3 as it is. 1 as it is. And 2 divided by 2 is 1. Next is 3. 3 1's are 3 and 1. So now I got all 1. I'm going to stop it. I just multiply. 4 2's, 4 2 2's are 4. 4 3's are 12. So the LCM is 12. So now I have to make all the denominators same as 12. So let's see, 5/6 plus 1, 2 minus 1. So with what number I have to multiply 6 to get 12? To 2. So up also into 2. So again 2 I have to make. How I have to make 2 as 12? I have to multiply it by 6. So into 6. Up also 6. So 4, if you see how I can make 4 as 12. To multiply by 3. Up also 3. So now let's do it. 5 2s are 10. 10 by 12 plus 6 by 12 minus 3 by 12. So 10 plus 6 minus 3 by 12, right? 10 plus 6 minus 3 by 12. So children, you have learned the board maths, right? So you know you have to do the addition first. So 10 plus 6 is equal to 16. 16 minus 3 is 13. 13 by 12 is your answer. Now as you can see, it's an improper fraction. So you have to convert it into mixed fraction. So mixed fraction means 1 by 12 is your final answer.